Stanford was a family decision, but it wasn't like my family made the decision for me. We were all about business when it came to the visit. That was a serious visit because, you know, they brought out like the Nigerian community.
Yeah, the entire Nigerian community at Stanford came
at a barbecue. Yeah, it was insane. And they said they practically like shut the whole place down.
We wanted somewhere where we knew that Nneka had the best chance to succeed. So when she made the decision to Stanford, everyone was like, okay. I didn't know what I wanted when I started the recruiting process. One thing that Nneka told me was that this is distinctly your experience. Find out what you want and then go after it. I wanted a place that would challenge me academically and then, you know, challenge me athletically. The decision came and I knew that the best place for me athletically and academically was Stanford.
You know, I'm the first one, I'm the guinea pig, but at the same time, people forget that she still has to do it on her own still, you know, and I think that Chiney does a really good job of understanding what she can do.
Basketball has a shelf life, and Stanford provided something academically that really broadened our horizons.
Nneka Ogwumike is an energy giver, and she's one of these players that's okay with doing the dirty work.
Prior to understanding the opportunities that the league could bring me, I was getting ready to actually go get my post-baccalaureate, where I could get like my prerequisites to become an orthodontist. And then, you know, Chiney was like, dude, like, what are you doing? Like,
you're supposed to be a number one pick.
I was like, really, you think so? I realized, you know, if I have the blessings that have been showered upon me to do this, then I can.
The pick is in, the suspense is over. Let's go over to Laurel Richie.
With the first pick in the 2012 WNBA draft, Los Angeles Sparks select Nneka Ogwumike.
It's just funny how something can just change like that just because of your mindset.
When she got drafted, I was like, oh, I'm coming for you, sis. Like, I'm gonna do that. Like, I'm gonna do that too.
Chiney Ogwumike joins her sister Nneka, taken number one overall.
It was such an amazing moment for our family. I remember telling her that now. I was like, Nneka, would you think, like, as awkward, gangly, tall girls, like, that we would be where we are today?
No.
We could have never predicted that. So it was a cool moment. We could really pursue our dreams and have a great platform to not only play, but also inspire others. Nneka set such a standard for us. That's when I realized I really had the best big sister in the world, because she pushed me, but then she always also empowered me.
I'm tired, man. You got it.
She does something and it plants a seed in my head. And I'm like, okay, she made it to Stanford. Maybe I can make it to Stanford. Maybe I can be her GPA. Maybe I can be a number one draft pick.
Our parents have told us, you know, basketball is basketball, but what you get out of it is more than just winning games and scoring points.
Chiney Ogwumike.
There is a higher purpose for us.
We all have our own different paths, but then we all want that same collaborative path of, you know, helping each other succeed. And that's one thing our parents told us and instilled within us.
The only thing stronger than a teammate is a sibling.
We were a team before we even knew what a team was.
It's over.